Spirit of public service. May each one be sustained by you, and may each discern your hand in their work and identify your image in the lives of all who have business in these courts. Lord, we hear again the words of the prophet Micah. He has showed you, O man, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you? To act justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly with your God. May these courts be filled with the confidence of your wisdom, the generosity of your mercy, and the power of your love. May justice be established, may your kingdom come, and may your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Amen.
Amen. Now, Zion, Timothy, and Emma.
Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. Salute. Pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Two.
This morning, the appellate courts of Alabama convened at St. Peter's Catholic Church for the 49th annual Red Mass. This special Mass, celebrating the beginning of the judicial year, is conducted for the purpose of invoking God's favor and guidance in the administration of justice. It is a tradition that dates back to the 13th century in Paris, London, and Rome. We've been very fortunate that St. Peter's and its dedicated parishioners have hosted this holy ceremony almost every year since its inception. And for this, we're most grateful. We thank you, Abbot Voss from St. Bernard's Abbey in Coleman, and Father Maria Doss here from St. Peter's for hosting the appellate courts this morning. Additionally, I want to thank our Supreme Court Clerk Megan Rodebeck and her staff for their assistance in coordinating our opening of court ceremony. I'd also like to thank particularly the participants in the Red Mass this morning, Justice Jay Mitchell, Presiding Judge Mary Windham from the Court of Criminal Appeals, Presiding Judge Bill Thompson of the Court of Civil Appeals, Judge Bill Cole from the Court of Criminal Appeals, Scott Mitchell, the Clerk of the Court of Criminal Appeals, Nathan Wilson, the Clerk of the Court of Civil Appeals, Sean Bloom, the Reporter of Decisions, Tim Lewis, the Law Librarian, and Dr. Rich Hobson, the Administrative Director of Courts. A ceremony is held annually to recognize the formal opening of a term of our appellate courts. But equally as important is the recognition of the members of the Alabama Bar who departed from this earthly life in the preceding year. How appropriate it is that we take time to remember them and their enduring contribution to our state and our profession. To our special guests, but most especially the family members of our departed lawyers and judges, we extend a warm and heartfelt welcome. You have honored us with your attendance here today. And let me take a moment to recognize some of our special guests who are here today. Justice Gorman Houston and his wife, Martha, Justice Terry Butts, Judge Sam Welch, Judge Bob Bailey, Judge Peggy Gavan, Judge Lucy McLemore, Judge Rizzardi from Huntsville, Judge Austin Huffaker from the federal bench, and Judge Monet Gaines, Judge Greg Griffin, and Judge Arthur Ray, and Judge Monica Errington were with us earlier today. I don't know if they're here right now. I've seen the Solicitor General Eddie LaCour among us today, Finance Director Bill Poole, Legislative Services Director Othney Latham, Roman Shaw, former judge, now general counsel at the Alabama State Bar, the governor's legal advisor, Will Parker, Commissioner of Agriculture, Rick Pate, and Don Harrison, the general counsel for the Department of Labor. I also see President Brandon Buck from the Alabama Lawyers Association and Terry Lovell, the executive director of the State Bar. Are there any others that I have over? Our state auditor, Andrew Sorrell, is here as well. Well, we thank you for being here. And with this, we want to proceed to introducing the courts. And I will start by introducing my fellow justices on the bench. And to my right is Associate Justice Greg Shaw of Davidson. To my left is Justice Kelly Wise of Prattville. To Justice Shaw's right is Justice Tommy Elias Bryant of Brantley. To Justice Wise's left is Justice Will Sellers of Montgomery. To Justice Bryant's right is Justice Brad Mendham of Dothan. To Justice Sellers' left is Justice Sarah Hicks Stewart of Mobile. To Justice Mendham's right is Justice Jay Mitchell of Homewood. And to Justice Stewart's left is Justice Greg Cook of Vestavia Hills. And I'm Chief Justice Tom Parker of Montgomery. To our left, seated down below, is our court clerk, Megan Rodebeck of Montgomery. And I now call upon Presiding Judge Mary Windham to introduce her colleagues on the Court of Criminal Appeals.
Thank you, Chief Justice Parker. I will now introduce to you my colleagues on the court. To my left is Judge Chris McCool. Judge McCool lives in Pickens County. To my right, Judge Bill Cole of Jefferson County. To my far left, Judge Richard Minor of Lee County. Judge Elizabeth Kellum could not be with us here today. I'm Mary Windham, presiding judge of the Court of Criminal Appeals. To my right, Scott Mitchell, who resides in Montgomery County. Thank you, Chief Justice.
Thank you. And I now call on Presiding Judge Bill Thompson from the Court of Civil Appeals to introduce his colleagues.
Thank you, Mr. Chief Justice. It is my pleasure to introduce the judges on the Court of Civil Appeals in order of their seniority. To my right is Judge Terry Moore of Mobile. Judge Christy Edwards of Pike Road could not be with us today because of a death in her family. To my left is Judge Chad Hansen, Trustful. To my far right is Judge Matt Friday of Pelham. Our clerk is Nathan Wilson of Montgomery. And I am Bill Thompson from Homewood, and I am the presiding judge of the court.
Thank you, Judge Thompson. I would also like to recognize the reporter of decisions for the appellate courts, Sean Bloom, the Supreme Court and state law librarian, Tim Lewis, and the director of the appellate IT, Blake Lunsford. And I want to ask all the staff of our appellate courts to please stand so we can recognize you. Oh, they're in the balconies, okay. Thank you. And we wish to express our gratitude to Marshal Earl Marsh of the Supreme Court and his deputy marshals for the dedicated service they provide in ensuring the order and safety of the courts, as well as for this building. And also want to recognize Lauren Potts, the assistant clerk of the Supreme Court, Chelsea McLaurin, and Mary Lynn Quattlebaum of the Supreme Court Clerk's Office for all their hard work in putting this together today. We would again like to thank all the participants in this morning's Red Mass and this opening of court. And now, our memorial address will be delivered today by the President of the Alabama State Bar, Honorable Brennan Buck.
Thank you, Mr. Chief Justice. Members of the Supreme Court, the Court of Civil Appeals, the Court of Criminal Appeals, fellow members of the bar, and most importantly, members of the families who we honor here today. It is appropriate that we open our courts by remembering and celebrating those lawyers who we lost in the last year. Before carrying on with the business of our judicial system, we pause to honor our fellow members who blessed us, the profession, and our communities in so many ways. I want to take just a moment and recognize one of these lawyers in particular, and that is Taz Shepard. President Shepard was the president of our bar just 2 short years ago, and he stood in this space just 2 years ago and gave wonderfully eloquent remarks that I can only hope to emulate. But our hearts are heavy across the street at the bar building following his death of approximately 1 year ago. Undoubtedly, you all remember the lawyer in your family as a spouse, a parent, a sibling, a child, an aunt, an uncle, or a cousin. And those family memories certainly are paramount. But today we reflect on their contributions as lawyers who rendered service to others. When we are born, we come into this world as nothing more than a son or a daughter, and if we're lucky, as a sibling. What we become beyond that time is a function of God's grace, the nurturing of our parents and other mentors in our lives, the choices we make, and the hard work that we put in. Your loved ones that we celebrate today became lawyers. And if that were all that they did, it would be quite a legacy to leave your family. To become a lawyer, they had to excel academically. They had to obtain an undergraduate degree, gain admission to law school, study law for 3 years, and pass the bar exam. That, in and of itself, should be enough to inspire future generations. But for virtually all of your loved ones, becoming a member of this bar was just the beginning of their legacies. Most individuals choose the legal profession, at least in part, because they have a servant's heart. They find dignity and honor in helping people with difficult problems. Your family members leave that legacy. Whether he or she talked about it or not, every working day, your loved ones spent time helping others in a time of crisis. I can promise each of you that there are countless people that you probably have never met and will likely never know who are in a better place today because of the work of your loved one. These people are quietly grateful for what your loved one did for them. But the legacies of those who have passed almost uniformly extend far beyond the assistance that they provided to their paying clients. They were volunteers. Whether they were providing free legal services to those who could not afford to pay, or donating countless hours of valuable time to their communities or their profession. They serve churches, schools, charities, little leagues. They chaired boards and they led meetings. They provided wise counsel, and people relied upon them for their guidance. In each of their own unique ways, your loved ones left their communities better than they found them. I was blessed to know several of the lawyers that we honor here today. I know these things to be true of those lawyers, and I am certain these things are true of every person that we honor here. So I encourage you, take a few moments to record your family member's legacy. Whatever was on his or her resume is only a fraction of the story. Write it down. All the contributions they made, all the ways they served, all the people that they impacted in a positive way. Share it with your children and your children's children. Let their legacies of service be an inspiration to your family, because now more than ever, we need servant leaders in this world. On behalf of the Alabama State Bar, I want to thank you for sharing your loved ones with us. We were blessed to have them as members of our profession. And those of us who continue in their footsteps will honor the legacy, their legacies, with a commitment to professionalism and service. God bless you, and God bless your families.
Thank you, Mr. Buck. And on behalf of the Supreme Court of Alabama, we thank you for your dedicated service to the legal profession. At the opening of court each year, we pay homage to those Alabama attorneys and judges who have left us in the previous year. I want to again extend a heartfelt welcome to all of the family members and friends of those we remember today. Your loss cannot be measured, nor can your loved one be replaced, but we can pause, even for a moment, just to remember. We assure you that their commitment to justice in the legal profession will continue to provide light and inspiration to all of us. At this time, I want to call on Clerk Nathan Wilson, who will provide the memorial reading.
May we pause for a moment to reflect and be grateful for all the Lord has given us, for all that He has taken from us, and all that He has left us. And may we be reminded, they are not gone who pass beyond the clasp of hand, out from the strong embrace. They are but come so close, we need not grope with hands, nor look to see, nor try to catch the sound of feet. They have put off their shoes to softly walk by day within our thought, to tread at night our dream-led paths of sleep. They are not lost who find the sunset gate, the goal of all the weary years. Not lost are they who reach the summit of their climb, the peak above the clouds and storms. They are not lost who find the light of sun and stars, and God. They are not dead who live in hearts they leave behind. And those whom they have blessed, they live a life again. And they shall live through the years eternal life and grow each day more beautiful. As time declares their good, forgets the rest, and proves their immortality. And may the lighting of this candle signify how brightly their memory burns in the minds of those of us who are family and friends and miss them forevermore.
Thank you, Nathan. And right now, the candle will be lit by Miss Ava Michelle Potts, the daughter of Justin and Lauren Potts. Ava is 10 years old and attends Hopeville Elementary, where she's in the fourth grade. Thank you, Ava. Our necrology will be read by Megan Rodebeck, the clerk of the Supreme Court of Alabama. And we'd like to recognize all the family members and friends. So would you please stand when Mrs. Rodebeck reads the name of your loved one?
John Michael Aaron, Gary Eugene Adams, Stephen Richard Arnold, Richard Arledge Ball, Robert Austin Beckerl, Alfonso Beckles, J. Jennifer Jenny Lynn Bale Thigpen. James Curtis Bernard. Gregory Scott Berry. Thomas Dwayne Bonds. Kenneth Hugh Bonham. Harry Franklin Brunner. Timothy Karstarfin Burgess. Daniel J. Burnick. Patricia Cash Burns. Guy Lewis Burns. George Marion Collin. Maria Bushell Campbell. Benjamin Sam Carroll. John Lawrence Carroll. Mark Elliott Cavadel. Delisa Michelle Chastain. John Robert Christian. Anthony Lee Sisio. Patricia Lynn Clem. Brandon Eugene Collins. Billy Earl Cook. Cheryl Lynn Peyton Cresona. Ricker Scott Daughtry. Terry Lee Dempsey. Timothy Lee Dillard. Ann Lamkin Durward. William Don Eddins. Silas Wayne Fuller. Dayton Foster Hale. Warren Levington Hammond. William Dallas Hasty. William Thaddeus Haney. David Elliott Hodges. William Freeman Horsley. James Gordon House. James Fletcher Huey. Jana Lynn Ifshin. Ralston Darnell Jarrett. Tanya Gail Johnson. George Hugh Jones. Richard Marlin Jordan. Brian Lee Justice. David Richard King. Philip Andrew Laird. Frank Edward Lankford. Charles Bennett. John George Lowther. Louis Bish Lusk. John Michael Manasco. Thomas Glenn Mancuso. Daniel Danny Harry Markstein. Ralph Edward Massey. Dominic John Matranga. John Alexander McBrayer. Martha Lynn McCain. Shirley Irene McCarty. Lewis Milton McLean. Stephen Paul McMunn. Douglas Allen McSwain. Billy Clayton Messick. John Hamilton Miglianico. William Jeffrey Moore. Frank Chadwick Morris. Dent Miller Morton. Larry Ronald Newman. Laura Elizabeth Nolan. Bert Powell Nugent. James Taylor Patterson. Andrea Pearson Pennington. Francis Anthony Poggi. Charles Neil Pope. Robert Leslie Potts. Sydney Rhodes Prince. James Lee Ritchie. Jasper Bearjohn Roberts. Robert Glenn Saunders. Howard Murphy Schramm. Gary Robert Seal. Taswell Taylor Shepherd. Henry Floyd Sherrod. Franklin Lewis Shuford. Justin Lee Smith. Clifford Morris Spencer. Louis Vastine Stabler. David Fitzgerald Steele. David Wynn Stevenson. Mose Lee Suddeth. Robert Troy Teague. Ronald Frederick Thompson. Jerry Lawrence Thornton. Richie Lee Tipton. Bartley Eugene Tomlinson. David Wayne Trottier. Jerome Tucker. Barry Dale Vaughn. Karen Marie Walker. Joe Walker. George Walton Walker. John Ray Warren. Taylor Devotion Wilkins. Karen Livingston Williams. Walter Cecil Williamson. John Newton Wrinkle.
Thank you, Mrs. Rodebeck. And during this process, I saw somebody that I had failed to recognize earlier, and that's former Judge Deborah Bell Passour, who's with us today as well. And she came and stood on behalf of several from her area of service. Now, Dr. Johnson, will you please give our benediction and the blessing over the food we are about to receive?
Now may the God who is both just and merciful be your guide and your counselor throughout this coming term. May you know the comfort of his presence and the courage of his spirit. May you be his light bearers and truth speakers to all whom you meet. And Lord, with sincere appreciation, we accept these gifts coming from your generous hand and gracious heart. Grant that we remain grateful at all times for your lavish blessings. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.
And I do need to add a postscript that there are several family members who could not be with us today and they will have a chance to see this and participate remotely through our online provision. And as we conclude this opening of court ceremony, I invite all of you to join us for lunch. And I want to particularly ask the families of the deceased to go out first so that you can get a table. This is an opportunity where you come together around these ceremonies, and it's an opportunity for you to visit and reestablish your relationships. We want you to get tables together, and we'll just fill in any empty seats after you get seated. So with that, we now stand adjourned.
All rise. We are now dismissed.